direct from Detroit, the Auto Channel presents exclusive press pass coverage of the 2008 Propane Engine Fuel Summit.
Well, I don't have to tell you that, you know, taking kids to school across the world is a real blessing. It's a treasure and something we hold very, very, very serious. And so, so does all of the governments. But we have the safest mode of transportation to take children to school. That's a fact, and there's statistics to prove that many times over. But yet we only have 50-some percent ridership. We'd like to see more. But while we do that, we maintain the safety of the bus that you've seen demonstrated. And I could show you even more graphic things. You do not want to hit a school bus. Do not hit it, especially a Bluebird. It'll slide your car underneath, and bad things are going to happen. They are safe. You've seen it. You probably saw pictures this past year of a bridge collapsing in Minnesota and a bus falling 37 feet, and yet every child walked off that bus. Bad things can happen, but it's still the safest transportation there is. And in that, to do a different fuel-powered system, we maintain that it's going to be as safe or safer. And I think we're showing that this is as safe or safer. Also saves the planet and saves the fuel economy for and transportation costs for the school district. So it provides a safe, attractive, and viable fuel choice amidst the rising diesel fuel prices. And yes, diesel prices have been coming down now, but so is propane. In fact, the diesel, when it was rising, someone here probably knows better than I, one of the marketeers I'm sure know that diesel was rising much at a higher tracking rate than propane. So it lowers the operating cost. You've heard that about, I'm speaking to the choir here, I suppose, but it lowers operating maintenance costs, utilizes a domestically produced fuel, again, that was mentioned all morning, meets all school bus FM VSS and CM VSS, including, as Al just mentioned, CM VSS 301.1, which is very stringent for safety. Meets the EPA emission requirements for 2010 production year and builds off an established propane distribution network of some 15,000 public and private retailers. So the infrastructure is there. We've been building the awareness and eliminating all the myths about propane, and we're there to keep this thing going. You don't have to sacrifice performance for alternative fuels. It performs and has performed, as I think our service dealer here will attest, that you don't lose performance, and it's just an excellent ride. Get out and get a chance to get a ride on it if you have an opportunity. And with that, get a little testimonial here from a servicing manager of Holland Bus Company, who Rick has had firsthand experience with it. Rick.
As Ron said, I'm the service manager of Holland Bus Company. Like I tell the owner of our company, I said, nobody ever calls the service department unless they have trouble. And the last thing I want our sales department to sell something that's going to have trouble. Basically, we have had this bus out on demonstration for a couple months now. And, of course, we're looking at fuel costs as a big thing, especially in Michigan with the economy we have here. A lot of schools are getting their funding cut, and their fuel budgets are way out the window. So that's one thing we're pushing on. And a lot of concerns that they have, questions we're getting from the technicians out there, the old technology, the old mechanical engine technology, basically a lot of it was diesel engines just turned into a propane engine, where this is a true gasoline or gas engine, and the performance has been great. The demos we've put on out there, people are very, very impressed with it. It has a lot more horsepower than diesel engines. We had a service school in our shop on Tuesday for Ellison Transmission, and we had this propane bus in there where they hooked their monitoring equipment too for the transmission, basically, but most people weren't paying much attention to the transmission part of it. The guys couldn't believe, running in our shop, it was so quiet you could hardly hear it run unless the air compressor kicked on. You could hear that over anything. We even had guys laying by the exhaust pipe, sticking their nose up the exhaust pipe to see if they could smell it, because we didn't have it hooked to an exhaust system. So you can see mechanics there, they're always looking at that kind of stuff. But we had a couple guys say, yeah, I can even spin the tires on this thing. On a school bus, I said, well, we don't need to be doing that, but that's how much power this thing has. So The only way, I guess, to overcome the myths of all the old propane is, especially the propane dealers, the one question that they have, a big question that they have is, where can I get this thing fueled? I think that's going to be have to be a learning process. If you look in town, there's propane dealers all over the place. Just that we have to get them to work with the school systems and stuff to make sure that they have a place to fuel these buses. The performance, like I say, everybody's just really impressed with it. And if you're a propane dealer, also get with your local Bluebird dealer and get one out to the people that you are, if they're interested in coming to propane, get them in there and have them drive this bus, because that's the only way they're going to see what this thing can do. And everybody that's driven it so far is very, very impressed with it. So with that, if there's any questions, I'll leave it up to Ron.
Thank you very much.
For more Press Pass coverage of all major auto shows, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.